Hello YouTube, welcome to the Katsuhito Channel. My name is Nick, and I'm back with another Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War video. And today, I want to be trying the campaign again. I've already tried to record the campaign multiple times, I'm having issues at the moment, but we'll see if it works. We'll know if we get past the first cutscene. I literally couldn't even load past the first, 30 seconds past the first 30 seconds of the cutscene. Jeez, okay. But yeah, so, let's try this again.
We must realize that no arsenal or no weapon in the arsenals of the world is so formidable as the will and moral courage of free men and women. It is a weapon our adversaries in today's world do not have. Let that be understood by those who practice terrorism and prey upon their neighbors.
Some U.S. intelligence analysts believe America is already in a state of war with the Soviet Union.
Are Soviet spies living among us?
52 American citizens have been taken hostage at the American Embassy in Tehran.
An unnamed White House official claims that a Cold War disaster could be just around the corner.
Mr. President, we have two names linked to the hostage situation. Arash Khadavar and Kasim Javadi. Just give the word.
It's time to send a message. There will be no more hostages.
The moment of truth is right here. Oh, frame rates are freezing. That's not good.
The police Adler?
This guy's done more for less. He'll look the other way.
Adler?
Glad you could join us, Hans. You remember this.
We cleared a move on the target.
Kasim is in his apartment, but he's well protected. I can keep my men out of the area for 15 minutes. I hope you brought an army.
We brought enough. Pleasure doing business with you. Come on. Woods is itching for the dust. You don't want to let him down.
All right. Okay, so what I've done is I've capped my FPS at 40, and I didn't record until I got past that first cutscene bit. So, that seemed to work well. Oh, I don't get a gun? Oh, there we go. Oh, do I want a Milano? Or both? Ooh. Well, I can't take both. Well, that's sad. I guess I'll take the AK-47, because that's what I like. Nice, okay. Hold on, one second. Alright, I just have to add you up.
Okay, we really need to take this son of a bitch alive, Adler.
Kasim has info we need. Everyone else can take him out. Apartment's just up ahead. Hans only bought us 15 minutes. We need to hit Kasim hard and fast. Let's go.
Okay. So we're gonna go fight one of the guys. Or go interrogate him, whatever.
Light him up, Mason.
Oh wait, am I Mason?
Go, go, go!
That's not covered.
Up the stairs.
We need to see him alive.
I need to cover the fire.
All right, I forgot to mention this is on veteran difficulty, in case you were curious. Okay, how do I get? There we go.
I'm moving.
Oh. He moved after he died. That was scary. All right, where'd they go?
I'm moving.
There they are.
Kasim can't escape. Find him.
I'm moving.
He's probably upstairs.
I'm moving.
Initiate a brutal melee kill or grab an enemy as a human shield. Press 1 to initiate takedown. Hold 1 for human shield.
Ah, go, go.
That's awesome. Oh, he died. Bye. Oh. Alright.
Move it. There's Kasim. Move it. Can't let Kasim.
Okay. Holy. I can't move. There's people here. Okay.
Hurry up. Watch it, Woods. We need him alive.
All right.
Softening him up a little.
That was kind of mildly terrifying. I haven't played a campaign in so long. Is he gonna peek? Ah! Ah! Don't kill me! This is really thin. Oh. The heck? Alright, we good? They're pushing really hard, and I'm just like over here cowering in a corner.
He's bolting! Keep on him! Jesus, this guy's fast! Go, go!
Ah! Oh, that's Kasim. Let's not shoot him.
We can work so far.
Oh.
You're up, Mason.
There we go. Talk.
Wait.
Tell us where Arash is and you'll live. You messed with the wrong people. Where's Arash? Definitely, let's be more aggressive.
I just handle the money. I have no idea where Arash is.
I don't think you understand the situation.
Americans have rules. You have rules.
You took hostages. The rules changed.
You have to tell my friend something. Or you have to tell my friend something. Or I can't stop him from throwing you over. Talk or you're going over. Yeah, I'm definitely being more aggressive.
He's in Turkey. He's meeting someone in Trabzon airfield tomorrow night.
Who's Arash meeting with? Throw. Time to join your friend. We've got plenty of cars down there. I kind of want to do that one, but I also want to know who... Here.
I swear I don't know. They only communicate with coded messages.
Evidence collected. Operation Red Circus. I told you he would talk, throw, time to join your friend, or capture you coming with us. I really want to throw him. I'm going to throw him. Sorry.
One down, one to go.
I get the next
Hudson, one.
Arash is in Trabzon, Turkey.
I love that was an achievement.
Kasim is out of the picture.
How long before we get Arash?
The team arrived in Turkey a few hours ago. They should be in position shortly.
Okay, so this is the mission that they advertised.
Airfield's just up ahead. Let's go find this shithead.
Priority is to ID Arash before things go hot.
I keep trying to like zoom in like in Minecraft, but then I just be prunning.
Hey, so check it out.
How do I? There we go. Track left
get
side.
Eyes on it, Mason. Arash might be in trouble.
I can't make out his face yet. I don't want to come.
Ooh.
He just diced a corner of the truck. That's gotta be Arash.
Hold fire. We need a positive ID.
Ooh. His friend got in the way. Yeah, I didn't think he could shoot him. Oh, I don't have any grenades. Okay. It's very hard to see. I'm very blind as a person. Oh, that's woods. Why is he all the way up there? Oh, okay. I can't just take my time. Apparently that's not a thing that's allowed. That's woods. I should probably get up there then. What the heck? I ran there like... Do I have to literally just run there instantly? And just like ignore everyone that's there? Whoa, okay, now I'm lagging behind a rock. Reloading, hold on. Holy jeez. Deploy RCXD. Oh. Accelerate. Boost. Find the button. Apparently can't kill those guys. Jeez.
keep on rush.
You should have freed the hostages when you had the chance!
Hostages? It was never about the hostages. His plan is already underway. You won't be able to stop him this time.
Stop who?
Perseus.
Bullshit. Perseus is dead.
Dead? All this time and you didn't even know. Perseus will watch the west.
Hudson will want to hear about this.
Let's
sweep the tarmac for survivors and get them lightly.
Fuck is Perseus?
You didn't think maybe to interrogate him a little bit? Like, clearly he knows stuff.
1943. Detailed information from the Manhattan Project was stolen from Los Alamos by the Russian spy known as Perseus. 1968. Vietnam War. Viet Cong soldiers, orchestrated by Perseus, attempted to steal an American-made nuclear bomb from a U.S. firebase. 5 days ago, while on a mission, we acquired intel that Perseus is in play again and planning an attack on the West. Perseus, the CIA's analysts consider him to be the single largest threat to the free world.
Mr. Hudson, we're all aware of Perseus. We're also aware he's more myth than fact. I mean, personally, I think he's nothing more than the Russian boogeyman.
General Haig, allow me to introduce the man best suited to respond to that. CIA clandestine special officer Russell Adler. He's one of the few people who even come close to capturing Perseus.
Mr. Adler, why should we take this Perseus threat seriously?
You don't have to, sir.
Yeah, then a lot of innocent people are gonna die.
Why do you say that?
Sir.
Every time Perseus has come into play, it shifted the balance of the Cold War. After 13 years of silence, if he's active, something big is gonna happen. Something that will affect the free world.
President, this is Jason Hudson and Russell Adler.
I know their names. Who do you think approved their last mission? Is the threat real?
Yes, sir, we believe it is.
Can you stop Perseus?
We can, sir. I've already submitted the requisition for my team.
Sir, their requests are highly irregular, most likely illegal. If the press gets a hold...
What the hell are you talking about? You know who we are?
Every mission we go on is illegal.
Sergeant Woods, plausible deniability is the backbone of our work.
Al, we're talking about preventing an attack on the free men and women of the world. Give Mr. Adler whatever he wants. Gentlemen, you've been given an important task. Protecting our very way of life from a great evil. There is no higher duty. There is no higher honor. And while few people will know of your struggles, rest assured, the entire free world will benefit. I know you won't fail us.
Yes, sir, Mr. President, sir.
Mrs. Hudson.
How long until we have a lead on Perseus?
They're about to get started. Adler's in West Berlin. He should be at the safe house soon.
Do you trust him?
I'm not the one you should be asking, Black.
What about his team?
It's a strong group. He chased down Sims, Azalea, even pulled some strings to get Helen Park from MI6. We'll get them Mason and Woods soon.
I'm not so sure about Park.
She and Adler have that business from before. Of course he wants her there.
And the new one?
Bell? Well, don't get me started. That's the one we need to keep our eyes on.
All right. Ooh, okay, first name. Katsuhito. Confirm. Last name. Confirm. Place of birth. We'll go with Europe. Why not? I'm actually American, but, you know, skin tone. We'll go like, I like this one. I think this is like my closest to my Minecraft skin. How do I? Did I get it? Skin tone. All right, let's go with this one. Gender. Military background. Oh, okay. So we got CIA. After a stint with the Marines, Bell joined the CIA. Bell? Who's Bell? Is it me? Serving briefly under Jason Hudson. Afterwards, Bell was assigned to Russell Alder's MACVSOG unit in Vietnam. Prior to joining Russell Adler's squad in 1967, Bell served with M16, or MI6. MI6. okay, it doesn't look like an I. Reaching the rank of senior leader, operations involvement classified. Okay. Prior to joining Russell Adler's squad in 1967, Bell served with MI6, reaching the rank of senior squad leader, operations involvement classified. While operating as a KGB agent, Bell became an asset for the CIA, eventually defecting to the United States in 1965. Bell later became a full member of Russell Adler's. Okay, I like that one. Psychological profile. Paranoid. Trusts no one. Tends to interpret the actions of others as hostile. Violent tendencies. Reliable in execution through questionable in result and in results. Exhibits a low to medium magnitude of cognitive dissonance. I'm finding this really hard to read. Prefers to act lone wolf. Prefers to act independently. Oftentimes questions authority. Oh, okay, they have, like, things on the right. Aiming speed increased by 100%. I trust no one. Okay. Bullet damage increased by... ooh, that's a nice one. Lone wolf. Initial sprint boost duration 3 times as long. That's also probably nice. Professional. Highly regimented. Sees team members as mission assets only. Lacks empathy. Full movement speed when using ADS. Fearless. Will disregard threats even in the face of immediate danger. Received explosion damage reduced by 50%. That's nice too. Reliable. Always planning ahead. Dedicated to following orders. Ammo capacity increased by 1 clip. That's not as good. Always expects the worst. Over prepares for a negative outcome. Lethal and tactical equipment capacity increased to 2. Aggressive behavior. Overly reactive. Prefers to escalate conflicts through physical means. Reload speed increased by 50%. Highly resourceful, adaptable to any environment or situation. Health increased by 25%. I think I might do that one. Calm under pressure. Outstanding mental aptitude. A highly effective agent when focused. Pain flinch reduced by 90%. See, if that was multiplayer, I'd probably do that one. But I might do Survivor instead. Systematic in thought, approach, and execution. Dependable, but also predictable. Weapon kick reduced by 25%. Can become fixated on accomplishing mission at all costs. Rate of fire increased by 25%. See, I can feel like some of these would be really well for, like, if I have, like, there's, like, whatever we want to call, like, a boss, basically. But then the survivor will be really helpful for just general surviving, which, yeah, would be nice. Damage taken when stationary is reduced by 30%. Has a team first mentality. Always last to leave the fight. See, that's what I would probably normally do if I was just doing it off of like the profile, the psychological profile. That's what I would probably do, but I don't necessarily. Actually, that's not bad either, but I think I'd rather just have 25% more health in general. Impatient. Shoot first, think later. Wants to take the fight to the enemy. Hit firing more accurate while moving. Yeah, no. All right, I'm going to do... Where is it? Survivor. And what do we got here? Oh, I can pick two. Okay. In that case, I'll probably pick one that does boss damage too. So, maybe bullet increased? Yeah, let's do bullet increased. Violent tendencies in Survivor. All right. Confirm your personnel profile. Confirm.
Bell, welcome to West Berlin. We've got a job to do. Mark.
Adler. Bell.
Get started. There's been a surge in Russian chatter in the last 48 hours. The CIA and the DOD are tapping their inside sources for anything substantial. So far, there are no leads on Perseus.
MI6 has come up.
What are you doing?
And we'll have to start somewhere. So we're going back here, Vietnam, 1968. One of our closest encounters with Perseus.
Shit. Some part of me always knew that mission wasn't done with us.
Berlin, Moscow, and
pull up everything
DC.
We've got on the attack in Da Nang and run it past Park. She'll cross-reference it with MI6.
We're looking for code names, encrypted transmission, Russian activity with NVA, anything that could be a lead.
Good.
What was he doing over here?
Bell, this is where you come in. As ex-KGB, it was a risk to bring you on, but we needed to think like that. We need that mindset again. Head to the evidence board. Trace our steps through Danae. Anything that could give us a lead on Perseus.
Okay, that's cool. They like use my background. Use evidence board. The evidence board. Use the evidence board to select the next mission. Replay previous missions or examine evidence. When you see this icon, new evidence is available that can assist you in the next mission and more. Alright, so we got Perseus, new evidence. The CIA is seeking the whereabouts and plan of the Soviet operative known as Perseus. And we have new evidence. Fractured jaw. Katsuhito Saisen, codename Bell, CIA, ex-KGB. In 1968, the CIA orders Russell Adler's SOG team to secure a valuable asset hidden in the Da Nang firebase. Okay, that's like the next. That's gonna be the next zombies map, right? Okay, that's the same thing. And we got new evidence. Nowhere left to run. Alex Mason, CIA operative. The president has authorized retaliatory hits on the two Iranian terrorists, Qasim. They just said his name. Qasim Javadi and Arash Kadavar. Qasim. That's what his name was, I think. I'm really bad at that. I see. I got three missions. That's cool. I like that. Examine evidence. Oh, look at this. Okay. Still at large. The Central Intelligence Agency knows a little of the figure it has dubbed Perseus. Records of his actions date back to the end of World War II, and suspected appearances are documented up through the Vietnam War. After that, only silence. The photo is the only clear likeness of the agency's archives. Analysts estimate its date from the mid-1950s. It clearly says February 2nd, 1960, not 1950s. What? I guess maybe that was filed and then not taken. I don't know. Interestingly, sometime around that same period, the elusive Soviet operative began to refer to himself using the Hutt's moniker. Perhaps as a point of pride. Or was a mocking nod to his pursuers. Then we have Black Ops. This mission authorization telegram was sent to Russ Adler from the mission, or from Emerson Black, the deputy strategist within the CIA's Directorate of Operations. A delivery for Perseus. After Russell Adler's confrontation with Arash Kadavar, an analysis of Trabzon airfield revealed that Kadavar may have been moving weapons to Perseus. It is speculation, though, as the recipient and destination remain unclear. What is clear is that Kadavar is somehow connected to Perseus, and Kadavar appeared to have knowledge of an impending attack of ambiguous nature. I can zoom. Nice. And I can rotate. Ooh, it says something in the back. What did it say? It says, encrypted intel acquired inside vehicle 1 of 13. Oh, so there's like more intel that I haven't gotten. Interesting. Alright, so then we also got this one. So I can launch this mission. During an unending standoff with Iranian hostage takers, the president authorized a black operation to take down two suspected masterminds, Arash Kadavar and his protege, Qasim Javadi. When confronted, Kadavar revealed that the Soviet operative Perseus had larger plans for the West. Okay, I see. So that one was the first mission I did. And I have evidence I can examine. Did I get all the evidence? Oh, I did! Nice! I don't know if you always get it or if that's just stuff that you have to do. I don't know. Okay. A key Middle Eastern asset for Perseus. Arash Kadavar was born moments after the Allied invasion of Iran on August 25th, 1941. As Kadavar neared his 20th birthday, the Prime Minister of Iran was overthrown in a Western-sponsored coup. Kadavar's father, a supporter of Mohammad Mossadegh, Mohammed's regime, was imprisoned, tortured, and summarily executed. The young Kadavar entered his teenage years with a powerful anti-imperialist stranger. Later, he would begin to reluctantly associate with agents of the USSR, who also had an interest in outstanding the American-backed Shah. Kadavar showed himself capable of exploiting religious zealotry if it served his political purposes. It is unknown when his relationship with Perseus began, but Russell Adler ended it on the tarmac at Trabzon airfield. The Apprentice. Qasim Javadi was born in northwest Iran 1946 inside the short-lived USSR puppet state of the Ashurban People's Government. He grew up in poverty, but showed exceptional promise as a student. At age 18, he left his family to attend the University of Tehran, intent on becoming a doctor, but dropped out dissatisfied. Qasim became increasingly attracted to the political resistance movement in Iran. After encountering Arash Kadavar at a secret group meeting, meetup in Tehran, Qasim entered the fold, becoming a key ally in Kadavar's plan to undermine the government of the Shah. Javadi's arrogance, love of luxury, and carelessness left him vulnerable to the CIA action once they chose to take it. Woodpecker. After killing Arash Kadavar, Russia Adler's team discovered that Kadavar had been moving crates of black market 1911s out of Turkey to an unknown destination. A partially destroyed manifest acquired on the scene of the plane crash mentioned Woodpecker, which could be the code name of the recipient or location. Family feud. As Russell Adler, Frank Woods, and Alex Mason watched from a hidden location, Rash Kadavar decided to execute someone on the tarmac at Trabzon airfield. It is possible the victim was an unaffiliated third party, but the Central Intelligence Agency believes that it was more likely an international dispute of some kind. Based on the 45 bullet extracted from the victim's chest, Kadavar was using a 1911 from the illicit weapons shipment loaded on a nearby plane. Okay. More than meets the eye. In Turkey, the Central Intelligence Agency sees several items from Arash Kedavar's person, including his eyeglasses. After a laboratory analysis, investigators discovered a narrow compartment embedded in the underside of the left lens frame. A curved hollow needle containing a small dose of tetrodotoxin, a powerful neurotoxin, was nestled inside a hidden compartment. Analysts speculate that Kedavar could have been carrying the toxin to either evade capture through suicide or use as an additional close-quarters weapon if otherwise disarmed. Okay. Greasing the hand. Hans Timmerman is the chief of police in the Amsterdam Centrum, the historical heart of Amsterdam, Netherlands. In 1976, Russell Adler first met him at a late-night poker game in Newmarket, where Adler not only took most of Timmerman's money, but also a mental snapshot of all of Timmerman's weaknesses. Jeez, okay. These included, but were not limited to, American dollars, fantasies about international espionage, and an irrational fear of exotic foreigners. He was just the man to exploit when Adler needed to remove the police presence from the area around Qasim Javadi's apartment. It would be a clear path from the back of Destier to Qasim's courtyard, and a short window of time to go weapons-free without fear of intervention. I just spilt water everywhere. Not really. Just a little bit, but a little bit better. These included, but were not limited to, American dollars, fantasies about international espionage, and... Wait, I already read the part. It would be a clear path from the... Okay, I read that. Lifestyles of the rich and infamous. Qasim Javadi purchased this apartment in cash less than a year ago, which exactly... no one within the Central Intelligence Agency believed was a clean transaction. Javadi had been partying with his friends, family, and cohorts in a seemingly endless New Year celebration when Russell Adler and company decided to make a surprise appearance. Many of the men there would be practiced militants, but for the most part, Adler expected it to be a simple affair. He wasn't wrong. Typical Woods. As Russell Adler prepared to leave Langley in late January, he briefly discussed his plans with Lawrence Sims to resurrect the old CIA evidence board at Safehouse E9 in West Berlin, starting with intel from their recently completed missions in Amsterdam and Trabzon. Frank Woods, who was listening nearby, walked up to Adler and placed a hand on his shoulder. Woods lifted up a matchbook from the bar in Amsterdam and waved it in front of Adler's face. Leaning towards Adler with a serious look, he said, "Hey, a souvenir for you, for your fucking board." Who is Adler to disappoint? Jeez, okay, that was a lot of reading. So this is the one I already did. Alright, well, I guess that's gonna be it for this video. If you made it all the way to the end, thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and leave a like if you liked it. And tell me what you liked about it in the comments. If you didn't like it, tell me what you didn't like about it in the comments so I can improve later. And, yeah, I just wanted to thank you again for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye!